This video is presented to you by www.testprepadda.com. Dear students, this is exercise number 7 of General Organic Chemistry. The questions of this exercise are based upon lesson number 27 to lesson number 33. Of General Organic Chemistry. This exercise has 5 questions. First, I will show you all 5 questions. Then I will explain you question number 1. In the same manner, other questions can be attempted. I request you all to attempt these questions and you can mail me your answer and solution at teacher@testprepadda.com. You can see this is question number 1. This is question number 2. This is question number 3. This is question number 4. This is question number 5. Now I will talk about question number 1. Here the question says, identify aromatic, anti-aromatic and non-aromatic compounds among the following. Different compounds are there. Dear students, in the lesson number 29, I have talked about the rules. Rules how to identify whether a given compound is aromatic, anti-aromatic and non-aromatic. You can see here, for compound to be aromatic, there must be a ring. Ring should be planar and the ring should exhibit resonance and there should be a loop of 4 and plus 2 pi electrons and this is known as Huckel's rule. Similarly, for anti-aromaticity, there must be a ring. Ring should be planar, there must be resonance and there should be a loop of 4 and pi electrons. And non-aromatic, those compounds which are neither aromatic nor anti-aromatic are called non-aromatic compounds. My point is clear? Now look at this compound 1. Here if I try to find the hybridization of each carbon, you can see this is doubly bonded carbon. That is why it is sp2 here. This carbon will also be sp2 here. This carbon is actually attached with 2 carbon atoms and 1 hydrogen, and that is why 3 sigma bond 0 lone pair means sp2 hybridized. Same criteria for this carbon also. This is also sp2 hybridized. You can see the overall ring is planar. Since ring is planar and resonance is there, how this plus is in conjugation with double bond, plus single double, and that is why you say resonance. And how many electrons are participating in this resonance? You can see one double bond means 2 pi electrons, and this 2 pi electrons means it obeys Huckel's rule of 4n plus 2 pi, because if I put n as 0, I will get this value as 2 pi. So 2 pi electrons. Ring is planar, resonance is there, and loop of 2 pi electrons. That is why this first compound is actually aromatic. This is aromatic. Now second one. In the second one, if you check, the compound is not aromatic because it does not involve complete conjugation. It does not involve complete conjugation. That is why this is non-aromatic. Okay. Now this compound. If I write the bond polarization, then the structure can be written as this. plus here and minus here. Now individually if I check both the rings, this is doubly bonded carbon, double bond carbon, this is positively charged cation, and that is why this is sp2 hybridized, sp2 hybridized, sp2 hybridized. Overall ring is planar, ring is planar, and at the same time how many pi electrons are there in the resonance? 2 pi electrons are there. That is why this ring is aromatic. Now look at this one. Here also this is sp2, this is sp2, this is sp2, this is sp2. Now if I talk about this carbon, here the lone pair, if the lone pair participates in the resonance with the ring, this will also become sp2. Overall ring becomes planar, and at the same time in the resonance, how many pi electrons are involved? 6 pi electrons involved. So loop of 6 pi electrons, that is why this is also aromatic, and overall the compound becomes aromatic. Now look at this one. Here also if I write the polarization, bond polarization, we do the polarization in such a manner that the compound becomes more stable. So here I will try to give this carbon plus charge and this carbon minus with lone pair. Now here you can simply see this ring is very similar to this one, and here we have already proved that this is aromatic. Here also you can see a loop of 6 pi electrons. So this is actually aromatic compound. Now if I substitute O in place of CH2, in that situation the compound will not be aromatic, because if I write the polarization structure, it will be like this, minus on O, plus here. Now you can see this ring has got a loop of 4 pi electrons, which is the character of anti-aromaticity. So here the compound will not be aromatic, but the given compound is aromatic. Now the fifth one. Here boron has got empty orbital. Boron has got empty orbital. Now because of this empty orbital, this conjugation will be complete. Double, single, double, single, double, single, and this is the empty orbital. So if I try to write the resonating structure of this compound, it will be like this. If I shift the electrons like this, then it will look like plus will be generated here, then double bond will shift here, double bond will shift here, and one double bond is already here. Now you can see this BH has got minus charge. Similarly, other resonating structures can be written, and during that you can see a loop of 6 pi electrons, a loop of 6 pi electrons, and that is why this compound will also be aromatic. Okay, now sixth one. Here you can easily say that the conjugation is interrupted by this carbon. This is non-aromatic. Okay, now look here. Here there is a complete conjugation in the ring, and you can see lone pair here and pi electrons. So during this delocalization, how many pi electrons are involved? 2 from here, 2 from here, and 2 from here. So total 6 pi electrons are involved, and that is why this is again aromatic. My point is clear. Now look at this. Here again boron has got empty orbital. Boron has got empty orbital, and if you find the hybridization of each carbon here, sp2 sp2 here, actually the lone pair oxygen carries two lone pairs, and out of two, one is participating in the resonance with the ring. That is why its hybridization will be sp2 sp2 and boron also sp2. Overall the ring becomes planar, and delocalization of 6 pi electrons or a loop of 6 pi electrons. That is why this compound is also aromatic. My point is clear. Now in this particular case, what is happening? Here also nitrogen has lone pair. But for this compound to be aromatic, this nitrogen should participate in the resonance with the ring, and these two electrons should not participate in the resonance with the ring. And in that sense, overall, if you see, 6 pi electrons are involved, loop of 6 pi electrons here, and each carbon atom you can find sp2 hybridized. Nitrogen here is sp2 hybridized because one lone pair is participating in the resonance with the ring, and trivalent, that is why 3 sigma, so it is sp2 hybridized. Overall, this ring is planar and 6 pi electrons are used. That is why this compound will also be aromatic. Now, this is a famous compound, tropolium. Here you can see there is a conjugation. Ring is in complete delocalization. And how many pi electrons are involved here? 2 from here, 2 from here, 2 from here. Total 6 pi electrons are involved, and each carbon atom is sp2 hybridized. So ring is planar, 6 pi electrons are involved. That is why this compound is aromatic. So this was question number 1. Dear students, in the same manner, you can attempt other questions of this exercise, and other questions are also based upon the same concept. You can share your answer with me at teacher@testprep.com. Thank you. This video is presented to you by www.testprep.com. Testprep.com provides free audio-visual lectures of different subjects by expert faculties, free online tests prepared by expert faculties to students who are preparing for engineering or medical entrance exams or planning to take exams like KVPY, Olympiad, etc. It provides a platform where students can interact with mentors to improve their performance in the exams. The mission of this online medium is to help students to achieve their goals. Log on to www.testprep.com to watch free video lectures on different topics, to download free revision notes, to take free chapter-wise online tests, progressive test, and mock test, to discuss doubts with mentors. Thank you for watching the video. To stay up to date with the latest videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Like us on our Facebook page, Test Prep Adda. All the best.